Hello, today I can announce that a mass-produced Examinx puzzle is now available. Just use the link in my description for purchase details. The puzzle is made by Sheng Xiao, though the first mention of a factory-made one was back in 2016 by MF8. This appeared on some of their puzzle boxes, and when I asked them about it, they said moulds are being developed, but it still needs a period of time. I've heard nothing about this version since. In 2017, Sheng Xiao showed their prototype, but it wasn't until May 2020 that the puzzle was finally ready for sale. So the first Minx puzzle was obviously the Mega Minx back in the 1980s. This was produced by Uwe Meffert. I think he just wanted to make a dodecahedral version of a 3x3 Rubik's Cube. He called it Mega Minx because the Minx is to do with like Sphinx and stuff, and he liked Egyptian stuff, and a lot of his puzzles like Pyraminx, and there was others as well that ended in inks. I think personally the Mega is just means it's like a Rubik's Cube, but kind of like Mega, it's more pieces. I don't think it had anything to do with like the computer thing where you can go, you know, Mega, Giga, Terra. I think that's just a coincidence, but I could be wrong. In 2005, Tyler Fox designed a puzzle with two more layers and called it a Gigaminx. He 3D printed masters and then cast the other pieces in polyurethane resin. Now he's jumped from three parts along an edge to five parts, because nobody really thought about having an even number at the time. You kind of assumed there had to have to be a middle one. Even if it was kind of partly hidden, you know, even if it's sort of that piece and that piece joined up, you'd still see some of it there. So we just didn't think, because of the shape, you know, like the pentagonal side, an even number would work. Obviously much later on we discovered it would. Of course, this is the mass-produced version that came out in 2009. So in 2008, Drusev went two layers more and had a Terraminx made. I think he did the same thing that Tyler Fox did. I think he had masters 3D printed and then cast the actual pieces out of resin. Because I actually have footage of myself holding it at one of the Dutch Cube Days. In 2010, this was mass-produced. In 2009, David Calzone and Flambeau went two layers higher and created the Petaminx. And in 2012, it was mass-produced. This is actually a factory-made one I've shown you before. It's a prototype that was never released. It's like a smaller version of the one that was eventually sold. Now, in 2011, Matt Banner designed and printed an entire Examinx. Now it did work, although it was pretty poor quality. He was just 15 when he did this. And of course, in 2020, the Examinx was finally mass produced. Now the most amazing thing in this entire story is back in 2014, Matt Banner had a 3D printed Jotunminx made. Now Jotunminx actually jumps a puzzle, because in between there should have been a Zetaminx or Zetaminx. But amazingly, Matt just went for something out of this world. And again, the quality isn't great, but it does move, and thankfully he's sticking it this time. Well, I'm sorry I couldn't show you more of the new Examinx, but it's literally only just been released, so I don't own one or have access to more than two photos. As I said earlier, use the link in my description for full purchase details.